And we're back for another episode. In this episode, we're going to be doing materia melding for my gathering sets. So I'm going to be doing it for Miner today. And I'm going to show you how the melding works and how to get the most out of each piece of your gear. Now, I've already melded my accessories. So, as you can see here, I'm using GP gathering of perception materials, because they're the stats which are relevant to gathering, obviously. And the reason I've gone for these numbers is because that is a cap for this gear. And the way I know that, if I quickly change to level worker. Now, the reason I need to change to level worker is because if you look at the bottom, you will see it says materia melding level worker level 50. So this is saying I need to be a level 50 level worker to meld this gear. So if I switch to level worker, I then press on my advanced materia melding, and then I'm concerned for now with the rings. Okay, these raptor skin rings. So what I'm going to do is I've already melded these four and I don't need to meld any more, and I want to show you why I know I don't need to meld any more. So if I select this one, this would increase GP plus 1. Now, as you can see here, this red, it says GP plus 0. And the reason it's saying that is because I've got plus 4 already, and 4 is the maximum amount of GP you can have on this item. So, and the maximum on this item is 3 gathering and 3 perception. And I determined that just by reading on the forum, sharing other people's experience, but also it shows you in game the fact that I can't increase it any further. And I can also do the same again. So if I look at gathering, plus 0, because I know plus 3 is the maximum. And perception, again, I'll just check the perception material, and again plus 0 because 3 is the maximum. So I have my spreadsheet that I set up, and basically I know that for rings the maximum GP is 4, the maximum gathering is 3, the maximum perception is 3. Now for the wrist piece, the maximum GP is 7, which is why I've gone for 3, 3 and then 1 on the GP, and then the maximum gathering is 4, maximum perception is 4, and so on. So each one of these items has got a limit of some kind, which I'm aiming to hit for all the accessories, which I have already done. And as you can see here, the maximum stats for the belt are 4 GP, 3 gathering, 2 perception. Now, I'm going to quickly explain how I do this materia melding. So, we're going to do this headpiece first. So, for example, this headpiece can have a maximum of 11 perception and 4 gathering, according to my gathering set and my statistics I have. So if I then switch back to armorsmith so I can meld it, go to materia melding, go to the headpiece slot, and I want this one here, the minor one. So click on the item. So the first material I'm going to put on is plus 5 perception. It's right here, so I'm going to meld that. Okay. Then the next one I'm going to do is plus 4 gathering. So, as I said, the cap is plus 4 gathering, and I know that already according to my list. So, for example, if I try and do gathering again, you can see plus 0, because I know it's already capped. So, now what I'll do is I need to put on 2 perception plus 3s, which I actually don't have right now, so let me go buy some. All of the gathering materials start with the word gather, which is, I guess, obvious. And as you can see, these are extremely cheap, like, you know, less than 300 gil each, so I'm really not bothered, I'll just buy a few. Sell them back later when if I don't need them. Now, the reason I'm buying more than I need is because when you're melding material onto additional slots which are not guaranteed, then the chances of it melding will be less. So I'm going to quickly show you what that means. So I go back here to Materia Melding, I select the headpiece. Now it only had these two guaranteed slots, which is I've already put in the 5 perception and 4 gathering materias in. Now you can still meld up to 5 materia on, but any additional materia after the guaranteed slots will have a less chance to connect. So for example, if I select here the plus I want the plus 3 perception, this one here. So as you can see here, look, 45%, there is a fair chance this meld will fail because it's not a guaranteed slot. So there's only a 45% chance it will actually succeed, not 100, which means if it fails you will lose the materia. So let's try. So as you see here, you are attempting to meld additional materia to an item. If you fail, you will lose the materia and catalyst. Proceed, yes or no? So I'm going to say yes. So I failed. As you see, that's the expression on her face. The materia failed, the materia is lost, so I have to just try again to get that extra materia in there. Thankfully for gathering, these materia are extremely cheap, so it doesn't matter if it fails a few times. I can easily afford it. Okay, and I'll keep going until it successfully connects. It is extremely unlucky for it to fail this many times, especially when the chance is 45%. Never failed this many times for me, but okay. Meld again. That's why I bought so many in advance, just in case. Okay, so now it's connected. So as you can see, the item, the helmet digger's helmet, now has 5 perception, plus 5, plus 4 gathering, and then plus 3 perception, which means plus 8 perception. Now the cap for possession is 11, so I can get another 3 on there. And to prove that, if I try and do a plus 4, it will say plus 3, as you can see. So I'm going to do again the plus 3. And this time, because it's an even more additional slot, it's got an even less percent chance to connect. You see here, 24%. So I'm going to meld that. So if you've ever been running around the towns and seeing people making these expressions, doing this sort of motion, this is what they're doing. They're trying to meld materia onto slots which are what is called forbidden slots. There you go, successfully connected. So now the helmet is pretty much at the cap. I could, if I like, get some extra GP on there, but it's not needed. Now if I quickly change back to my miner and show you the gear. Now the sweet spots, as they call them, for miner are to have as much perception as possible, so we will be going for the maximum perception in every single slot, and also to have at least 600 GP. Now with my accessories already melded to the maximum, I've already got 606, so I don't need any GP on any of the armor pieces. And that's a good thing, because basically I'm going to be melding my fishing set exactly the same way. And as you may or may not know, fishing has absolutely no use for GP whatsoever. There's no move on fishing that requires GP, which is why I've designed my materia melds this way. So I'm just quickly updating my spreadsheet to show the progress on my melding. So, okay, so let's now do the body piece. So to do the body piece, I need to again switch back to level worker. And then, materia melding, I will go to head, body, hands. Okay, and then I will select miner's shirt, because that's what I'm interested in. So the first material I'm going to be putting is gathering plus 5. Now I have found for gathering that the rank 1 to rank 3s, rank 1, rank 2 and rank 3 materials are very, very cheap. Like the rank 3s are even like 2,000 gil each, which is extremely cheap. But the rank 4s, so like for example, the rank 4 of this materia, the Gatherer's Guri Don Materia 4, is actually worth 70,000 gil, which is not worth the money. I will never use a plus 4 when the plus 3 is only 2,000 gil. So, okay, do this one. Okay, so now again, I need to put in 2 perception plus 3s into the forbidden slots. So I can hit the perception cap. Okay, I succeeded the first time, luckily. So let's try it again, minus shirt, perception plus 3. Unfortunately failed, so let's try again. Okay, I think I have enough material left to try just once more. It's always important to check here to make sure that you are going to get a useful statistic from the gem. If it says plus 0, then don't bother, it means it's adding nothing to the gear. Okay, so I'm out of perception 3, so I'm going to just go buy some more. Like I said, thankfully extremely cheap, so I don't have to worry about the money. Just buying a few, just for the sake of it. Okay, so if I try again. So again, go to miner's shirt. I want the perception plus 3. Failed again. So yeah, so basically you could just keep doing this over and over again until it does eventually successfully connect. There is nothing you can do which will increase the chance, you just have to keep trying. There you go, that's connected. So now I will do the gloves. So I want the miner's pair of, here you go, miner's gloves. So the first materials I'm going to do are gathering plus 4. Do gathering plus 4, meld. So I am going to link in the description my melding chart that I use in order to do this, just so you can use good materials that will pretty much get you to cap without wasting any gil on rank 4 materials or anything like that. They are not necessary. And also, if you try and do a fifth slot on these items, if I quickly show you, so if I go back to, say, the miner's shirt, and I try and do a fifth slot, for example GP, then the chances of it succeeding is only 14%, which is really not worth it. And because I've already passed the 600 GP mark, I don't need to worry about it anyway. So, okay. So we go again to miner's gloves. So I've done 2 plus 4 gatherings. So now I need to do a plus 4 perception for the cap. And like I said, these materials are worth like 300, 400 gil each at the most, which is really, really cheap, especially compared to the crafting melding. Okay, so one again, perception plus 4. So for the gloves, the maximum stats you can have are 8 gathering, 4 perception, and 1 GP. And like I said, I just won't bother with the GP because it will add absolutely nothing to me, given that the cheapest ability for gathering is 50 GP, and there's no way to get to 650. Okay, so that's the gloves done. So now if I do the legs, pair of minor slops. So I want, because the maximum for this is 6 gathering and 1 perception. So I'm going to do 2 of these. So for example, if I do plus 4, it will only say plus 3 because the maximum is 6. Okay, and then 1 perception. Now there isn't a plus 1 perception gem, so I'm going to use the rank 1 perception gem even though it'll only give plus 1. Okay, so that's done. So now simply do the boots. So I want miner's work boots, there you go. And this one is plus 1 gathering plus 6 perception. So I'll put 2 perception gems first. That's a guaranteed. Now in order to do these crafts, you need these carbonized matters, which I'll quickly show you. Here now I need 1 plus 1 gathering. So as you can see here, you do not possess a proper catalyst. A high quality catalyst then necessary will be used. So because this is a rank 1 materia, I only need a grade 1 carbonized matter. I don't have any grade 1 carbonized matters, so I'll use a higher quality one, grade 3. So you can use higher quality carbonized matters to meld lower quality materia, but never the other way around. So you can't use, for example, a grade 1 carbonized matter to meld a grade 2 or 3 or 4 materia. So I just keep lots of the grade 3s because they're just as cheap as the grade 1s. Okay. Let's see again, minor boots, need 1, gathering, meld, yes. So this is Materia Melding in Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. I find it to be a very interesting concept, the fact that you can meld 5 slots even if it's only got 2 on there, with less chance. There you go. So effectively now, according to my spreadsheet, my minor set is finished. So let's look at my miner now. So if I look at my statistics, you can see... Oh, actually, no, it's not finished. I'll take that back, because I forgot to do the offhand weapon. So on the offhand weapon, I can get a maximum of 20 perception. So the stats I'm going for are 371 gathering, which I've already got, 387 perception, which is the maximum possible in the game, so I'm going to get another 20 from the offhand weapon, and at least 600 GP. So I think the maximum GP you can get is like 628 or something, but there's absolutely no point to get it because, as I say, you can't use any ability that costs less than 50 GP. So unless you can get to 650, there's no point. So anyway, if I quickly change now to Blacksmith of Materia Melding, I want main and offhand, and now I want the minor weapon, this one here. And again, I only want to increase, I want to use 4 of the plus 5 perceptions. So the first 2 are guaranteed, but the second 2 won't be. And perception helps with the chances of getting high quality gear, so it's always a good idea. It's actually only the first one that was guaranteed. I just happened to do this one in one go. So again, let's try this. 8-19%. Be kind of painful. Wow, three in a row. That was lucky. So, but I've now run out of the perception materials, so I'm going to just grab some more. They are extremely cheap, thankfully. So I want the rank freeze of this, and as you can see, yeah, 2.4k, I'll just buy 8 of them, whatever. Because I can use them for my other crafts, and if I can't use them, I can just sell them again, so. Let's hope I don't blow up 8 of them just to get one more additional slot. So we've got a sledgehammer, perception plus 5, 11% chance, which is kind of low, meld, yes. Wow, look at that. 4 in a row, one shot. How much money have I saved doing that? So 20 perceptions. So if I go now minor, you can see here on my statistics, 371 gathering, 387 perception, which is the highest possible in the game right now, and 606 GP, which is a sweet spot to be. Anything 600 plus is more than enough. So anyway, that's how you do materia melding for gathering. And I hope you liked the video, and again I do suggest using these material melds I've done, because you see they're extremely cheap. I will never need any rank 4s, and I've still managed to hit the perception cap anyway, and that's it. So thank you for watching, and as always, goodbye from me and goodbye from Mithrie.